lot of people say, how to avoid heart attack, doctor? You think there's a block in the vessel is a cause of the heart attack? No. Block in the vessel is a good business for me. I can tell you I want to bypass that and give you, take about 5 lakhs from you. But that block has been bypassed by nature and or God long ago. Otherwise you would live. Suppose you get 100% block, how can you survive? So as the block appears over a period of years, the collaterals come. I have a ace patient in Mangalore. This man saw me about 40 years ago when he was about 50 plus. And he brought an angiogram where all vessels are blocked. Every single vessel of his heart was blocked. And he said, doctors asked me to immediately have bypass surgery. So I looked at the angiogram. Nature had done so much a bypass. His whole heart was so beautifully supplied by blood. So I told him, look, you don't require anything. Nature has done the job. We can only do a cosmetic work on top of it and harm you. So don't worry. But his children were all in America. So they thought, this village doctor doesn't know. So they took their father to America. They went to Mayo Clinic and showed the angiogram. That Mayo Clinic doctor said, send your father back home. Ask him to have a peg of whiskey every night and enjoy life. He will not die. Don't touch him. And that man is alive now, 94. And you can see him today, 94, ramrod straight. He had 3 cancers after that in the last 40 years. Survived all the cancers also. And this is a very quick man. If you look at, if you read Mangalore newspapers, this man has now taken the voluntary job of chief traffic warden. Early morning at 9 o'clock, he's about 6 feet, 4 inches height. He'll put on that police dress and come and stand in Hampalgatta and direct traffic. At the age of 94, and he's so fit and healthy. Why is he healthy? He has a healthy mind. I always say, mind your mind, your heart will be fine. If you don't mind your mind and fill the mind with hatred, jealousy, greed, ego, depression, etc., you will die of a heart attack very soon. The cause of a heart attack is not the block, but a bad mind. It's a bad mind that attracts a clot, and the clot kills. And if you had a block earlier, you probably don't die. If you didn't have a block, if you were very young and didn't have a block at all, if you get a heart attack, you will die instantaneously on the spot. That's called sudden death syndrome, which is different from heart attack. Before the heart attack occurs, you are dead. So your heart on postmortem looks normal. But you may have died of a heart attack because the heart is called electric death. And this happens. It happens in 2 circumstances. A, if you are an alcoholic, if you drink a lot of alcohol, your wiring inside the heart gets eaten up, moth eaten, and wiring gets snapped one day. So you suddenly drop down dead. But if you have a heart attack and you are old and have many blocks, you will never die. You will have chest pain, come to the doctor, make the doctor rich, and you will go on and on and on, jog on, and you don't die. So the secret is the block in the vessel, coronary vessel, is not the cause of a heart attack. Recently they did a study in America. They took angiograms of people, lot of people, and everybody had some block. So they didn't interfere, didn't tell them, but wrote down, this man has a block in the left anterior descending artery, and if he gets a heart attack, he must have a heart attack in that territory. Like that they left and then observed them over the last 20 years. Now a few of them did have a heart attack, but never in the area where there is a blocked vessel. So blocked vessel is not the cause. Where there is an open vessel, that got a clot and that had a heart attack. But even then what happens is, we simply frighten you because that's our business. Just now I was talking to a friend of mine sitting here, and he was saying he's absolutely fine. But his sugar level is very high. So he had a very pertinent question, very logical question. Doctor, doesn't your body get used to a higher level of sugar? I told him, yes, it does. Because he says, I'm absolutely fine. If doctors give me tablet and try to bring my sugar down, I feel miserable. I said, you are absolutely right. Because one of the greatest researchers in hypertension, I told, his name was Sir John Pickering. And Pickering said, after you start a patient on blood pressure drugs, he loses all the 3 things in the American Constitution enshrined to for man: life, liberty, and pursuit of happiness. Life, you are not sure, because with or without drugs you may die. Liberty you don't have because you have so much of restrictions. Pursuit of happiness is a thing of the past. So If you take drugs, you become an ass. But lot of thinking doctors are there. I was telling that gentleman sitting there with me, I said, there is a young doctor in Pune. I met this boy, very ingenious doctor. He has devised a method of not controlling diabetes, but curing diabetes. You have no diabetes at all. At the end of which, he will give you a certificate. Cured of diabetes, no treatment needed. And that certificate, and he will give you a medal, a gold medal. And he will call every year people who have done that course. And this year he called me as a chief guest. I had about 2,800 people who got the gold medal. They called Muktotsava. In Pune, he had 4 days of Muktotsava. Tripathi. Pramod Tripathi. Actually, one of the participants this year who got the gold medal from me was our former Home Minister, Sushil Kumar Shinde. And Shinde told me, sir, with about 20 units of insulin 3 times a day and 3 tablets, my sugar used to be, average used to be 240. With this boy's treatment, it has never gone beyond 110. And I'm very happy and healthy now. So this is what is possible. But unfortunately, commercial medicine is different from really real scientific medicine. And if you want to know the scientific medicine, it's very easy to live a healthy life. Healthy life, if you want to live, have a healthy mind. And the word that kills you is that arrogance. Do you know who I am? I'm a high court judge. That I starts the illness. When once you say we, it starts wellness. All that you do is convert that I into we. That's all, as simple as that. So the things that kill you are the negative feelings in your mind. The kill things that keep you healthy are positive feelings for others. If you want to be healthy and happy, make others healthy and happy. I always tell my students, each one, at least reach one. Reach one life so that he is made happy. And a lot of people go in search of happiness. I'll be happy when I get my daughter married. I'll be happy when I become the Chief Justice of India. I'll be happy when I become the Prime Minister of India. You'll never be happy. If you are happy today, you'll be happy all your life. So happiness is a journey. Happiness is not a goal. And what is a simple formula for happiness, tell me? Catch hold of a man who is unhappy, make him happy. And happiness will come back. Happiness and love are like the mirror, you know. Christina, an American poet, has wrote, if love is what you give away, love is what comes back each day. So it comes and hits you back. So you love another person, world loves you. You love yourself only and don't love nobody. And hate others, you kill yourself faster. So friends, convert yourself, illness to we, wellness. You will all be very healthy. Then a lot of people think, oh, if I eat this, I'll be healthy. If I run a mile every day, I'll be healthy. If I run marathon now and then, I'll be healthy. All not correct. You are healthy if your mind is healthy. You don't have to even run nothing of the sort. You can eat anything. As long as you don't eat when you're not hungry, you are fine. If you don't eat too much and become obese, you are fine. Eat what you like.